that they're scoring for him that he talks about is really a result of great offensive execution. This is a club that works well together. They get great looks, and they also score in transition. That's two fouls now in the first half, so we'll see if they let him try to play through. It's going by Hill. They're still on top here, but they need to calm down with the ball. I agree, they give up 6 points on turnovers already this quarter, so they've got to take care of the basketball. Outside, Martin.
Hello. So what's he going to do if you got the address to 1 minute? You know, come as well, man, too.
Supreme.
If it's a
How the fuck you drive 40 minutes past? Ain't got GPS? That's what I told her. She's talking about she don't know where Sonic at. She even goes to one by a high. That's how it went. I was a GPS one. I told her the exit. I had sent to the exit here. I told her the exit was 290 and guess me. So how far down past 290 and guess me did you not realize that he was going too far?
Who is that, though? I understand it's your main bitch, nigga. Talking to you like that?
Control over your bitches? What you mean? Control over my bitches? I have been driving out here, man. What you mean? Do I got control over my bitches?
Bitch got the food, but she ain't
got
it.
I told him I'm getting her in the sign of this club.
Very unselfish. I think this has been an efficient performance. And I agree with you, Steve. Very few questionable decisions, if any, from him, as he has always looked for the best shot. Every trip down the floor, I like the fact that he's judicious in his approach. Setting the floor for the Clippers. You know, one of the things I love about Chris Paul is that, like so many of the great ones, he plays with a chip on his shoulder. Off the floor, he's one of the nicest people you'll ever meet. But when he starts, he's an absolute killer. Man, he makes a lot of tremendous plays at that end of the floor. We see it from him every day. Beyond the arc. Take a look at some of the numbers for Blake Griffin, 17th in scoring, with a top 20 ranking in field goal percentage. He's got a nice job of being a good luck for the world. Hey, one more thing about his top 20 points for game average. I mean, he's a massive factor for the team.
Wait, ain't this 2-9 in the beltway right here?
And Chris Paul, Steve, he touched on his competitive nature. And yet he remains friendly with a lot of players and other teams off. Well, he's highly respected and well-liked by
what's his zip code? 77445?
A player, a great competitor. That new school kind of mentality. Kind of buddy-buddy in your free time, but once the ball's in play, no prisoners are taken. He's balanced that, walked that line really well. And that rebound pushes their margins to +5 on the board. Solid job on the glass. Well, it's just part of what he's done. He's been built in the big year. It shouldn't be overlooked. Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. He did not look too happy about some of the things he saw on the court. So I would expect some changes here. I think it's the right move, quite honestly. I mean, they look sharp or at their best out there. So take the timeout and give yourself a chance to regroup. Eric Bledsoe checked in for Grand Hill. The bucket gets to Zappalosha. Stolen by Bledsoe.
missed calls back. Hello. Unadulterated power right there. I mean, he ripped it down with hello. Take no chances for that guy. Back to Durant. And taken away by Paul. Stolen what you said. If you trip, I mean, shit, no, I mean, so what? So, you know, you spend that many toxicity. I said, so you just gonna scream at me and talk to me, that's gonna do something, that's gonna pull something. Anything could have happened. Chill out, dog. Calm down. You ain't too fucking too bad.
Textbook offensive rebound right there. I love that. Go back to the bucket. Any team loves to get.
Like I said, man, I'm sorry you had to go out your way to see me. I ain't doing it purposely. Like, I mean, I told you I ain't know no Sonic Boy, right? I got on internet. I Googled that shit. That's what popped up. You know what I'm saying? The Minnesota Sonic. When I went to the website, put in my address and pulled up the Minnesota Sonic team. This shit was 2 miles away. And that's the address I sent to. Yeah, this is always tomorrow. I mean, see, I don't see you got Clippers tomorrow. I wouldn't see you Clippers. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't got to be mad. It's always in the time. It's like, you know. Damn, when you come by, you already got to drive back faster than me. You got the address, right? You got the address, right?
Yeah, this is a very good free throw shooting team. Look at the numbers. Impressive. That's been one of the strongest aspects of this team this season.
Yeah, they're very defensive. See, she was, I didn't think she was coming. She don't even bring me no food. That's all the money brings. Yeah. They thought she was cool.
They know how important it is to fix that inability at the free throw line.
She probably fucked around and still got it. She got it. I know this man was the same spot.
And Russell Westbrook has subbed in for Eric Maynard. And here we go. And that one's good. Westbrook's a catch.
You better. I'm down to Jay got an Xbox on.
And the Thunder, when they acquired Denver Curtis, they considered him to be the final piece of the puzzle. That rebounder, the shot blocker, intimidated him to be the playoffs athlete. And the Thunder making a change here. Bobby's checking in.
Dang, I'm going to Black Panther. That's bullshit.
Here comes Westbrook. 17-point lead, they're taking two balls in his foot. And whistle the kick.
Yeah, I see that.
And stolen by Barnes.
Can't even take the ball off him.
Over Westbrook.
That Barnes, oh, he just stole the ball, man. Yeah, he stole the ball, and then he passed it, bitch.
I said, threw it off the side,
yeah. That's right, man. Can I change my camera, bitch? Let's see. That might be how niggas is winning and shit.
long as you want to play that bitch, I'll close it and shit.
Oh, I thought that was me.
I'm trying to see how I want to make it, because I couldn't even see the three-point line. That's the lineup
out there for the Thunder.
You
see
two more of them. That's a player. He
was feisty. He was not super talented, but what he was tough. He loved to defend. He would pick you up 94 feet and just harass you all over the court. And it's called penetrating. So the whistle blows.
I had to learn how to play on the weird ass camera angle, go there and play tab, bitch ass. Second half, we play half and half, play the second half on a weird ass camera angle, I know how to play on it. Dog just gets ass. Put on the camera angle while you see the court doing nothing to some threes all day long, he can't stop them all. That's what I'm saying. Why can't I get Chris Paul going like that? Nah, he can, but you gotta get him going. Determines on how they set the field. If you release it before they get you, they're gonna cut back to the basket. You know what I mean?
Six on the shot clock. For the three, offensive rebound. Sevalosian is just to Perkins. Westbrook against Paul.
Good. And the Kyle double team on the other defense.
He's been so valuable to this team in plays like that. Ball with the ball. Westbrook picks him up.
Slam dunk by Butler. So that was some old nigga. Where the fuck this nigga came from?
That's the magic. And then he catch that hoe.
Yep, very exciting play to see that. Especially when it hits with that big slam like that one. All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
My man playing Street Fighter with my man, I love Nancy. Yeah. Oh, okay, I got this green posted up. What's wrong with her doing that? It's all right. I'm gonna call it. Come on, you're coming.
Outside Griffin. Walker sets a screen for Griffin.
Man, that nigga Jordan.
He's the
man. That nigga Jordan.
Big
Mark.
Rebound
category.
That
nigga
big
boy.
Big
done. And he paid
off on the
scoreboard in a big way.
With the chance. Yeah, this
I'm sorry, he just blew us up.
Yeah, I like the fact it was wire to wire, too, guys. Fantastic job.
We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. Paul with the three. Paul can't get that one to Paul.
Really nice. Shit.
He's trying to shoot his way out of his core spell. I don't know about that shot. Well, everybody likes to think that they have the best home court advantage in the league, but when the GMs were surveyed last year, they picked Oklahoma City first, followed by Utah and then Denver. But it's something that you could argue about for days. There's a lot of great home court advantages in the NBA.
But then recovery. And out of bounds the Thunder,
game's a tough
Kevin Martin is checked in for Kevin Durant, and it's Maynard in for Russell Westbrook. And the Clippers making a change here as well. Bledsoe's checked in. Zavalosha kicks to Martin. Just four to shoot. That's the 3 points.
Oh my God.
Like right there too, like make sure you can put a picture of us, any kind of extra shit, maybe background talking, just some extra shit you can kind of fill in right
okay,
there.
Okay, just
you know what I'm saying.
All the extra footage that we probably was just. Camera and rolling over there, really.
Like in the just in the day, you remember how like we at the gas station was,
yeah,
we just kind of like talking, stuff. Fucking around and shit.
By 2 days, I shoot something. I just put a bunch of like one at least part where it's just a bunch of different backgrounds. It won't necessarily they'll go in those spots, but
okay. Just
having them in the row so you can come see. Or I'll just upload one with the one shot. You know what I'm saying? The one shot I'll have a whole bunch of different backgrounds.
Okay.
We'll
do that. Do it to it. So you say about 2 days for that. So all in all, probably about just think about another week or so. Alright. And I'm gonna try to get you that forward by the end of this week.
Okay.
For the mixtape.
Yeah.
And then you can
have it when the video come on and go up.
Yeah. And the logo and of course your shit on there. That's pretty much it. Alright.
Call that girl. I thought you was talking to her.
Alright, y'all take it in. Spike yourself, fake ass, dreaded like 50 cents. He ain't gonna never have his hat off.
Put a roof on. for this Friday coming up.
I mean, you making good money doing it?
Look around 2,000 or challenge around. So some are like 3,000, some are making around that way. It's on the side of the house. And about the supervisor I got here, we don't buy guys for that whole, but that's the most we offer is $500 too far. We get all the way. Yeah, well, but we sell a premium product. A top of the line of rigs that we're
you're
putting
it
where
you damn
when
you see here
guarantee it, you know
damn well it's gonna be
here. We'll have a policy. We'll have an instrument. We don't shortchange and cut quarters. When we charge that much for someone, if they pay their deductible, we give them a 10-year rig. That means, you know, 30-pound felt instead of 15-pound felt. We give people Ridgeville all the time, you know, when it's not bought. Yeah. Give me my money.
We play around here.
Alright. I'll finish this shit later.
Yeah, 50 with dreads on your liquor. I mean, look at this nigga. Turn it up. How I got that?
Keep it, homie. You do this. You get five, baby. It's like you. Make it happen.
One for the mansion. Two for the Maybach. Three for the bitches. Four for the highlight, five for the fame. I said five for the fame. Man, you always got to go on.
I'm going to ask
you
a bit.
What the fuck are you laughing at? You get mad at me for? Man, fuck this shit, man. I'm going to stay skinny. That way my dick look bigger. Only how you throw the clothes I want to do when
what
I grab
the
bitch
right? Back. Get that right?
Get back, bitch. I'm out of here. You can have that shit, man.
My nigga. That's all right. Niggas gonna go hungry tonight. Hope that was enough. How is that all right? Man, you ain't even have nothing. You just, you gonna both on the right
side. I ain't want the beans. We ain't have no spoons. What we was gonna do?
We ain't flip forward. Nigga ain't even shit. Nigga ain't say nothing. Just gonna leave nigga that bought the food with the left. That's how it is. That's how it go though, huh? Nigga that bought the shit don't get no first choice.
Nigga wait till the rice gone and say,
wait till the rice gone and say, what the rice gone?
You see me eating rice.
I didn't see you eating.
I'm so sorry.
He didn't call this shit eating.
You probably downstairs, man. You want me to send you my? Tell me in a minute.
Four hours. You tell the team?
Tell me. 15.
I'm coming right over here.
I know. It's
I should with my head.
Oh, give me two. Two.
That's fine.
He was gonna produce this movie too.
Just happy.
Yeah.
That
little
dog,
beer's
mom,
going
down tonight. That's all. That's it.
No problems. Give me a call
when
I
can send you. I can say.
I'll do that.
Except for
the years
that I'm trying.
What's up? What's up?
I didn't even
what's
look
up?
Right from
the
grid, so
it's hard.
But
you
know. At all.
Geology.
I don't know what the fuck I'm like, what is that? Just the way she was, I don't know, walk back in, like, y'all hear her, right?
His mom.
Ain't none of them, you're sorry.
You
got
to where you said that? Huh?
No, she was even holding me. I don't know what color I didn't look.
$10,000.
Afro Warrior shit.
You know how much of color this is worth? I ain't never seen a 66 thing like this kind of shit, man. All you got to do is put some rims on it.
She was talking shit.
System in it. Ooh, you know, look, I give you $12,500 for it. What is going on here? What, are you gonna let that Bob Barley here outbid me on this car? Come on.
Harry, for heaven's sakes, let the kid have the car. You're too old for it anyway.
Hmm. Wait a minute. Look, you know this has always been my dream car. Damn. I just want my roses.
Oh. Yeah, it's not
I
robbery.
Was leaving, but it's only a car, not for me. Look, let me handle this. Why don't you go outside and enjoy your minivan? It's what you like.
I need this deal. Look, here's my final offer. $11,000. I'll go get my checkbook right now. Deal?
I'm sorry, kid.
Man, this is bullshit.
Okay.
I'll be right back. $1,000.
Because he's a
natural, man. Man. Why are you going to do that, man? You see that? $1,000.
Well, I don't get it. Doesn't the old guy know
he'll
get a chance to drive along? He don't look like he's...
Oh, he's just... Yeah. He's supposed to go out on top.
tickets for you and Mom. Last game of the season.
Oh, good looking out. Ha, ha, ha. Oh, that's my rope. Listen, don't go past the door.
Yo, I'm going to run back to campus. My ride better not come back smelling like weed either.
Oh, it ain't. But it might smell like sex, though.
It's stupid. Are you jogging back?
Yeah.
Okay. 6 minute mile. Keep your pace even. I know. Okay. Hey.
$11,000. You're a man.
From your mouth to God's ear.
Hey.
You
don't
have to sleep
by yourself. Just
closing
and look still for the night. Man, he's gonna fucking mother guy. A couple blocks
down
the quad. I walked. So Sean finally called. Yeah. What'd he say? Nothing. He just offered to give me the tickets and brought me over, and that was it.
Damn,
did he say
nothing? No.
What was he supposed to say?
I don't know.
I appreciate you walking me home.
Snuff.
Okay.
Walking slow,
naked.
Yeah, right there.
Why don't you have your brother call me instead of you?
I don't know. I mean, I was busy. And, you know, I wanted to make sure you came, and he's.
Why is his teeth like this in his movie, y'all? God damn.
Well, if you want to go out,
he got an extra overbite.
Well, I'm asking you now.
That
pretty smile.
Now, give Richard Dawson a good. This is some shit. I guess the director makes the difference, huh? Life on how they keep the line doesn't put a good director in somewhere that's gonna help.
I didn't feel up to that.
This is the first movie I've seen this thing in here without no guns anymore, folks.
Come check me out.
I'll be there.
Texas?
This
supposed to look like Texas.
Come on, look at the looks.
What?
At least I had to ask. That
shit said Lakers and Chargers. Did you see that?
Lakers?
Yeah.
That's what you can do when you make movies. You make your own shit. It's my favorite two teams.
They put the L on them and had
baby on the new helmet. Yep, it's the same Lakers L, too. Atlanta Hawks.
My brother like, why the fuck is he so excited?
Oh, she getting excited. Look at this field, man. What the hell?
You know about the real football field with the shit.
That shit looks worse though.
They made it fit inside of their warehouse. That bitch ain't even 100 yards. I ain't even seen it 50 yard line yet.
Thank you.
Okay.
Who is his brother, the nigga? Mario Van Vitten?
Bring it up.
Let's go, PA, Gator 92 at Bob's section up front. It's Vince, brother's last chance. Yeah. Yeah. The action's horrible, man. The way they shot it ain't too bad. It's watchable. Very watchable.
I think that's all he wanted to show, you know what I'm saying?
Cut it, what I tell you. I was concerned, that's the 50 thing about it. Make sure it looks good. You know what about this city right there?
Or the city football field. Make this, yes, he been live right there. What's that? When he caught the ball.
You know what I'm saying? He egotistical. You know he gonna put himself in the good.
But you see, but
yeah, the carpet came over there and jumped. How y'all can't duct tape this shit down, man?
You see
that? Yeah. Sorry for that.
Somebody, do you see the 5 yard line? They fucked up on the engine right there. I promise, dog.
Yo, man. That shit coming out, that shit came up real bad. They couldn't even make the coaches have a big headset like in the pros.
They don't even look. You see that? You see, y'all ain't screaming, look. That's the 10 yard line. That's the 5. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. When it is on it.
Yeah.
It look good though.
Yep.
That's stupid, man.
Yeah, we just won, but we didn't
matter because the pass. His acting makes
it horrible
though. Yeah, good position.
This is stupid, dog.
Nah, that was a horrible face, bro.
I see that nigga. He trying though, man. He trying to get out there. He know that's why he shooting all these bullshit moves.
Dude, that was so fucking cheesy, dude. That was so cheesy.
Gosh.
How you doing, man?
You know, all right? Done, yeah.
That was
looking
good.
Oh, yeah, man.
You know,
getting never quitting it.
We've been here.
Guys, man. After, but, I don't want to talk bad about it. I know why you're doing it. I'm like, good move.
Look, I didn't know those were your CDs. You never sent me. I thought they were mad. They were sitting here for longer than I put them in there.
Oh, DJ Hammerhands over there?
What I tell you?
The iPod experience?
Tell you to get your ass in there.
I was like, whoever has a good taste of music right
now. Something worse than to bump your boy.
I want to talk about it.
You know, you remind me of Michael Keaton on Beetlejuice.
Oh, man, that's
crazy. No. What you were doing before, she just did the way you were just like talking the way
you know, like, I've had some bitches tell me that before. I can be as crass as him. I'm trying to go for it. That's funny.
That's putting stress on your heart.
I take that. He's pretty cool, really. That's for a white boy. Thank you, sir. Now, you didn't do that dog style, did you?
I think I did it right. You tell me.
Blowing flames off.
Why? I placement of the tumor.
Any kind of on my head like 3 times. More
damage. Nah, you fucking kill a fly. Just sit behind it, man. They always fly off backwards.
Radiation.
Flies never go forward. They always fly backwards.
Point it this way. Swing.
What we have to do is we got to take away
this way.
Watch fly. Yeah, you always go behind it. They take off backwards. They never go forward or sideways. Everybody tries to get them in front.
Another thing, you got to cut their flight path off where they're playing.
No. Go behind them. Slam in the back. They take off backwards every time.
How you know all this shit?
He was a flyer.
No. White boys can't jump, but you can't shoot. So when you sit still on somebody for a long time. Yeah. Let's just say when you're sitting still watching somebody for 30 days, you don't do too much. You just know what flies do. You know what I'm saying? You don't know 1,000 yards, 3,000 feet.
I'm the white boy. You don't want to move. Don't forget, the moon is spinning, so it's going to the right.
About half a centimeter every 125 yards.
Want to test it?
Special delivery.
We just a little
embarrassed. Hey, what you playing over there?
All this stuff is just
going to be on the line.
No, no, watch that. Man, I got it.
Every time.
That's why I like talking to you, because I learn every time.
I'm a sensei for nothing.
Sensei.
You know, I was going to talk bad about y'all, but now you're sitting in here, so I'll wait before you leave.
Yeah,
that's
what I mean.
I can't talk about either one of y'all while y'all hanging out.
You call him a monkey?
No one has to know.
He still looks good.
No, no, no. I don't agree with that. You might as well tell him anyway because they got to find out.
Ernie. I could
do it.
I'm talking
about
the
university.
I'm talking about the dog.
Worst case scenario, he can drop down tonight or 11.
I got all my shit in one place, and he heard some of the basic tracks.
He was doing it just with the drum machine and the beat maker and what was that other machine?
Just the EA-1 two chords.
It sounded like a thin synthesizer.
EA-1 and whatever the blue one is.
They got the factory sounds, you got like a
well, I changed them up a little bit, but yeah.
It's got like the mod controller.
It's kind of house, right? You know,
frequencies and resonance.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. But
the modulated is the first thing.
If you said, oh, they're cranking it off when I came home, or the
same time, where I live,
I live with a drummer.
My old drummer, right?
Because I heard him 2 years ago.
He wants anything you got.
Dude, would you please
put
that
shit in the trunk?
He's going back over there. He should have brought my shit. My drum machine. There you go. Tyler. Go, white boy. Tyler. Tyler. Really? Ain't that where like all the kind of rich white folks live? Yeah, don't they got a lot of money and shit? All those people in Tyler? Yeah, some old money.
You call it old money.
Real hood wearing cross-burning Klansmen and shit over there. Trust me, man. It's step away. I love you boy to death. Really?
Yeah. Well, how do you feel about that?
Ah, man, that place is kind of badass.
What's up with you?
White women with blue eyes. You just want to tell them. Well, girl, that shit don't matter.
I see some
finest girls out there in the world, right, boy. But they put on that fucking, they get that big hair going, that makeup and shit.
That Peggy Bundy.
Yeah, me too. As soon as they open their mouth.
That's what, man, that's some, I call it snicking.
See what I'm saying?
The snicking dude.
I'm like, girl, take this shit.
Hey, how's you sticking with the snooky dude, man?
Hey, yeah, I mean, has nobody ever told you that shit looks bad? You know, I mean, you know, they were probably cute as hell when they were little kids, and, you know, they've been diddled since kindergarten, you know, but quarterback likes them, daddy been picking them up, you know. That's why they can't walk till they're 2 or 3 years old, because everybody picks them up and shit, they're so cute. Oh.
You see what
I'm saying?
Ugly kids aren't at all rare.
I'm serious, man. I mean, you know, my neighborhood, motherfucker. Shit, they be, you know, mom be dragging them across the street. They be waiting at the lights and, you know all the light changes. And, you know, you go up, like, up in Thailand and see them already ain't walking at 18 months. You're like, kid ain't walking?
I know, baby.
I mean, come on, 2 years old?
Yeah.
I mean, that shit, you ride a big wheel and shit already, man. Shit, you probably already ride a tricycle.
He was trying to give you something all that lightning.
Tell him, they call it the Lost Ward now, but, you know, it used to be No Man's Land. Then it was fucking, the No Ward, and now I say, you bitches only caught the Lost Ward because you get lost when you come on the bridge. I'm like, Trey's that way, motherfucker.
So now?
Who y'all, you say you did some tracks for?
Oh, just, yeah, man, basically getting back to my electronic shit, man.
No, I mean, like, what's your, who you've done in the past? I know how you told me, but.
Everybody, man. I mean, I can't remember all that. You know, fuck, dude, you know, like, the biggest band out of here is Blue October. Man, fuck, we used to not let Justin in the fucking club over at Rockefeller's, man. We used to not even let him in the club. fucking The Hunger, probably, you know, people that you've heard of, Nine Inch Nails, man. I fucking do work for TDT Records, so I go up there all the time.
You done some hip hop stuff before, right?
Oh yeah. Young Jeezy, fucking, really, man, fucking, it's probably the best shit out. Really, the most known shit. You ever heard of any of the guys called Wartime? They're from the North Side. And I don't, even though I'm from the South Side, I did a lot of stuff with the North Side guys. Because my brother up here is Slim Thug, fucking Paul Wall, pussy ass. You know, Original Sensei, which I had to, you know, fucking ask him if I could use that. I said, everybody's calling me Sensei, man. Fucking, he's like, that's cool. J-Dog, this shit, man. You know, that, video that they came out with right after First 48 where they're holding up the little white kid on the t-shirt. I forgot the name of the song. That's my little brother. He used to roll through his shot.
Yeah, that's the one where he get canceled. I don't want to see this shit for a time shit.
Yeah, you like me. I can't watch nothing depressed, man. That shit be creeping up in my eyes.
Jesus. And I've seen the photos of this nigga get.
Man, I don't know. I can't watch a lot. All I watch on TV is History Channel. Fucking, my TV watching is History Channel before I go to bed. You know, you can shut your eyes. You got that nice monotone voice talking. You ain't got to watch it and shit. You know what I'm saying? Get some education with your fucking TV.
Yeah.
Like, what do you do all day? I'm like, make music, play. But yeah, I got away from my electronics for a while because I was with that band, Superna. I mean, they ripped it up, man. That was a good band. It was good enough for me to do all that shit. But dude, I had a kid, so I kind of laid off for about 2 years, 3 years.
You said you had a kid?
Yeah.
Okay.
So now I'm like fucking, I don't know. It's the first time I've just basically gone back to doing what I do. You know what I'm saying? Fucking.
I can feel that.
Yeah.
That's what I'm pretty much at right now.
Beats, man. I mean...
Hook up.
Yeah, man. Like, you don't know this, you don't know. Like, shit, man. I told the dude that was selling screw, was fucking lean. Stop selling lean. The motherfucker ain't more in the bathroom. You're killing him. He'd go 2 or 3 days without peeing. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's, because he copied me. I say it away, because I used to take rap and speed it up for the clubs, right? So I could, you know, work that into my sets. Well, he took it the other way and slowed it down. You know what I'm saying? I didn't get no selling it. I'm like, man, you need to stop selling. Because he don't want to do a lot of that shit. Stop going to the bathroom. Shut your fucking system down. I told him that. 2 weeks later, motherfucker was dead.
Who?
Fucking, this motherfucker right here, I'm DJing in Stars, fucking No Limit. Master P, first time I met him, I'm DJing at a club called Stars. It's right over the border of Louisiana. This is about 94. And fucking, they just fucking really started cracking down on the fucking weed over there. But that's, everybody used to have to go over there to get it after they kind of ran it out of Fort Arthur and fucking out of here. And I mean, this place would pack them in, like 2,000 fucking Friday night, Saturday night. Pack them in. The first time I ever met him, he walked right up to me, right in the DJ booth. Motherfucking Eclipse, you know, he's a big old naughty headed motherfucker. Looked like he got spears and shit hanging out of him. Fucking, he walked right up.
Out. somebody that's missing in the picture and be like, don't. And that was going to be my slogan. Be like, hey, you getting tired of having somebody missing in the family picture? You know what I'm saying? Kodak moments. Hey, everybody's captured in the moment. You feel me? And you sit there, motherfuckers that want to do, you know, I don't give a fuck what it is. Like, if y'all want to do a hot air balloon ride, we going to be there and y'all can have fun. Don't worry about taking pictures. That's for our job. I guarantee you're going to capture shit that you ain't never thought you could capture.
You know, the crows, they had to complain.
You got like, video around the photographer,
they rented us our own hot air balloon to follow them. We
need to do that. No, what you do is, we already be in cahoots with all these different places. The skyline, we'll get a discount just by bringing them the deal. It'd be beneficial to them. Of course they want to see some shit like that, nigga. They'd be like, fuck yeah, we're gonna have a balloon fire with all of this shit for y'all to get pictures. But for using our website and y'all promoting and bringing us clients and shit. Then fucking y'all go ride go cars and shit. You know what I'm saying? We'll be out there with y'all having fun. Taking pictures of everything. Like, videotaping and shit. But think about that shit. Motherfuckers from Cowboys and they want to go horseback riding with their family. Y'all go out there horseback riding. They're walking along getting fuck videos and photos and shit.
See, that's what I always like. That's what I do
make the most. Because think, that's what everybody loves when they go to Astroworld on the roller coaster. They come back and go to that one little hut, they take pictures, they got pictures and shit.
hour ago we was looking at.
Trust this color blue in here. When they talk to the receptionist, they make them want to trust her. You know what I'm saying? We hit them with a move like that, and then my kid may go to a weight room or another area.
gonna shoot the commercial in the air, right? The little nigga that came, the little big nigga. Not the
Thank you. probably do.
Can't play baseball forever, can
you? You see?
Hold on. Don't have a screen.
Nope.
Papa says you wanted to see me?
Yeah, all right. Come on in. Let's see.
Another one bites the dust.
Like record everything. Put one up there, like one of them, you know what I'm saying, facing different ways.
Sessions and shit. And then come out in the morning.
That's how it is.
And then go to the hunter suit.
And for his daughters. Oh, for his daughter and him.
Right here? Right here? On what dog? What you talking about?
Oh, you got it. Oh, you said why we're going to do it.
Your daddy truck not running right now, huh? You got the gun?
Yeah.
You got to get a gun. Here's my key, man. Not working.
Another key and another lock. I shouldn't have the same key and lock for both of them.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hey, Kodak. You was right there when he told me that was going to drive off that. Hello? Hey, what's up?
Hello?
Hey.
Hey, what's up?
No, what are you up to?
I'm
just
talking all day.
Hello, bitch. That's what's up. Hello. Get your ass on up. You're on your way to the hoop? Hit that pole.
Yeah, I got a
group hit that pole. It's on the trash. I know. You said, I ain't know what you said. I didn't hear what you said. Can you see me, bitch? I'm ballin' like a motherfucker. Ballin' like a motherfucker. Can you see me? Can you see me? Can you see me? Yeah. Ballin' like a motherfucker. Ballin' like a motherfucker. I'm hot. Ain't no bitch nigga.
Whatever you need to accomplish the mission.
Painting. Paint these nuts.
You
said paint these nuts.
I
said I'm painting.
She can't hear me that way. I can't hear you.
I'm painting.
Silicone implants. I don't want the water.
And off the internet, I'm telling you out there,
no,
friendly death machine spinning up. Friendly care package inbound. Tracks have been erased. Good job. Mm-hmm.
And I
go up in the bathroom and I throw up, nigga. I thought I had to take a shit. I go in the bathroom, nigga. As soon as I get in the bathroom, shut the door, nigga, I get thrown up all over the bathroom, folks. Nigga, I come outside, everybody sit on the back and nigga smoking. Hey, boy, you ain't got no cleaning supplies, dog. I just threw a bottle of them up in the bathroom and everybody bust out laughing on me. So I told them this little story how it was funny. I said, man, look. Man, you can save all that shit, you know, that's just a moment that we gonna laugh at years down the line, niggas. We gonna laugh at how, man, this nigga, I don't know that shit about this nigga first time coming over to see this nigga down there, fuck up the whole operation, man, just spill water and killed everything. You know, I was just fucking with him, he was like, yeah, man, he said, man, it was real shit, you know what I'm saying, you just chilling with you, you know. So, nigga, he's supposed to be in white jerseys, fool.
No, he not, nigga. The home team is the...
Nigga, the Rockets don't wear white at home.
Chicago, in his third year with the LA Clippers. Now here's
Crawford, now averaging 17 points a game. Barnes, on the arc. Kevin Martin with the rebound. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, Westbrook with it, and Crawford picks him up defensively. On goal, Magic coach, Vinny Del Negro, a 14-year playing career, 12 in the NBA, played a couple years in Italy. His best NBA years too with the San Antonio Spurs.
Yeah, Vinny was an excellent shooter, particularly in the mid-range. Loved to come on close screens along the baseline, throw into the lane, and shoot over the top of the defense. Had a good feel for the game, run the floor a little bit. So a nice, solid player in the NBA, and has turned into a good coach as well.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here. Last time they met was in Los Angeles. Take a moment here, check it out. Now that the mid-season grind is well underway, look at the Clippers. And, of course, Oklahoma City, tied right now.
I just got to say this. I mean, the Thunder fans have really been spoiled since the team moved to Oklahoma City. 4 years in, they've made the playoffs in all but the first season.
Marginal kitchen.
Boy, what a fantastic opening quarter for them. Yeah, it sure has been. Look at the lead they've jumped out to already. Impressive.
Crawford against Westbrook. Tipped away. There's 42 seconds left to play. Oklahoma City. It's a 10-point game. They want to keep it rolling here following the win against Dallas.
Boy, they were so good offensively in that game. It seemed like they had an open man to go to every time down the floor. Probably wasn't the best defensive effort that we've seen from their opponent.
Well, they should give some of the credit for that. I mean, they threw a few new wrinkles into their game plan, and the defense wasn't ready for it. Los Angeles Clippers coming to this one following the loss to the Wizards in Washington.
And that result was no surprise, Clark, because they played very loose with the ball that night.
Yeah, they were carefree. Put loose and fancy free with the ball, doesn't get it done. And how often do we see it, Steve? A team that loses the turnover battle loses the game. And a double-digit lead, moving on. The second quarter, and a very convincing performance from the Thunder so far.
Yeah, they have been fantastic offensively, really coming out strong. They've lit it up.
Yeah, they have. I mean, very much in control and shooting the ball extremely well. So, with Westbrook on the bench, this is who Scott Brooks has out there. Serge Ibaka and Kendrick Perkins are their physical front line. Mayer is out there with March, and it's Sepulosia in its small forward.
Well, everybody knows around the league that if you get in Blake Griffin's way when he has a head of steam going, you're going to end up on his poster at some point. So since coming into the league, I think he's become as intimidating a player as we've seen.
I agree. That's not posterizing Keith Weaver, Steve, although he does a bunch of that. When he gets a steal and has a free lane to the basket on a breakaway, there's a good chance the crowd will see a mini dunk contest for Blake. Martin from outside. Out of bounds for Clippers head possession.
And a chance here to check out some of the numbers for Chris Paul. First in steals, second in assists. And of course, he's been extremely accurate from the free throw line, ranking in the top five in the NBA free throw percentage.
And just to mention his steals again, Steve, he's one of those guys who's in a zone where it's like he knows what almost, Sepulosa's got his first basket of the night.
Something happened, James. He has had 10 straight points coming in the paint against this team.
Well, they got a collapse in there, and everybody's got to be conscious of it. It's a team effort in protecting the paint. Control the ball, and then everybody's got to get in there and keep the defense locked down. Well, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Jordan dishes the ball. He feeds it to Griffin.
Kevin Durant checked in for Sepulosa, and Russell Westbrook is subbed in for Eric Maynard. Here's Westbrook. Again, the Thunder score.
Well, none of these defenders were quick enough to step out and get a hand in his face on that jump shot. Big mistake there.
And the Clippers call time here.
You know, you look at how dominant Russell Westbrook is statistically in just about every facet of the game. The scary part is he's still learning how to play point guard. And he's a two-guard at UCLA, and really kind of a combo guard his first year in the league, but he's handling the ball and distributing and doing a better job than other people.
Blake Griffin is third. Here's Paul. To Griffin. Rejected by Martin.
He just can't get a good feel for his shot at this point. It's one reason they're losing.
That's a major mental mistake. I mean, there's no other way for me to describe it. He didn't know where he was on the court. That's a basic fundamental. You have to be alert to where you are. Talk about Westbrook's upside.
He said, I woke up and I realized that I had you there in my right. Something on the commercial.
Is justified, but it's over the top in many cases. You've got to keep in mind the big picture. This is a young developing point guard who has already accomplished an awful lot in what I think is going to be an all-NBA type career.
Westbrook double team. They double him with Jordan. Westbrook with the bucket. Westbrook's got 4 points this quarter.
Yeah, when you play against him, Kevin, the first thing you want to address is making it harder on him to go to work down low. If you let him get position inside, it's going to be a long night for you. Not to mention, guys, he's got those rush hour handles. He's getting a lot of tight spaces the way he handles that ball. He's able to dissect the defense as he
timeout is called. First of the game,
he's got to learn to do the thing. I'm
going to see what he's going to do.
I used a while away with TV. I told you that not easy to guess him too much.
Very good, but I think as his skills develop,
he's got the
potential to be great.
I got all them sunnies pulled up.
Yeah.
I sent the mission address to the sunnies. Oh, this nigga stole
it. And for DeAndre Jordan, Steve, you mentioned his upside. Right now, almost all his points come across the lane. Right around the rim, close in.
Yeah, you'll rarely see him shoot from outside of the restricted arc area, really. I mean, his free throw stroke shows you why. He's got work to do there. He can develop something offensively, a jump hook and a mid-range jump shot. Watch out.
And the shot is good.
That's exactly what they had in mind on that possession.
Westbrook drives in and out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession.
Oklahoma City sits in the NBA statistical standings right now. First in scoring. First in free throw percentage. And then number two in rejection. This is a team that thrives on blocking shots and takes great pride.